Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm making this Key Cosy. This is how it will work. It has little ring there to attach your keys, pom pom on the top. Embroidery around the eyes I'm making in another tutorial, please see the link in description below. And another tutorial, I will be making this like a keychain, just a special mug, beer mug. And for this particular mug, I'm using drops number 9, recycled cotton. And my hook is number 5, 3 millimeters. I'm using stitch marker. And I must say that this is quite easy tutorial, suitable for beginners, and it takes very little yarn to make, so it could be your scrap yarn project. Let's get started. Let's start with magic circle or magic loop, creating the loop, picking the yarn and pull it through. And I will make 8 single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I will close magic loop, but not all the way. I will need this hole to be left. Oops. Finish the row with slip stitch into the first stitch, not into the one that I was to start the magic of the magic loop, but into this first one. Then I will make chain of 3, 1, 2, 3, and start making popcorn into the next stitch. I will make 5 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, four, five. Pick the first stitch of first double crochet and take that loop through, chain two. I will make popcorn into the next stitch, 5 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then I will find my first double crochet, insert the hook and pick the loop through, chain of 2. 1, 2. Popcorn into each of those stitches. I should have 7 popcorns. So next stitch, 5 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Insert the hook into the first double crochet, picking the loop, taking it through, chain 2. Next stitch, all the same, 5 double crochet for popcorn, 2, 3, 4, 5, and picking the loop, chain 2. I will make 3 more popcorns. 1, 2, 3. I want to finish the row with chain 2 and I will insert it into the chain. This was the chain I started the row. Just picking out the last stitch, slip stitch. For next row, chain of 3, and I will make popcorns between those popcorns I've got. This is the space between. 5 double crochet, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Doing exactly the same, inserting the hook into the first double crochet stitch and feeding the loop through, chain 2, and I will make another one into the same space. 5 double crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is getting a little bit tight here, but that's fine. Insert your hook into the first, picking the loop and taking it through, chain 2. Next gap, I will be making 1 popcorn. And then I will be making 2 popcorns. 1 popcorn, 2 popcorns, 1 popcorn, and the last one I'm making 2 popcorns, chain 2, and I connect the row into the chain with slip stitch. I can tighten this end, just pick any stitch and chain 2. This will secure it. Now I'm taking yellow yarn and connect with my crochet, making chain of 1, and I will go with single crochets all around, making 2 single crochet into each space, 2, 3, 4. Into each space between popcorn, I'm making 2 single crochet, and I will go all around, At the end of the row, I placed 2 single crochet into the last space, and now I'm ready to join the row. So I will just continue as I go. I will make first single crochet and then second single crochet, and I will make as many rounds as I need without any decrease, without any increase. If you try your keys, it should fit inside. I will make 10 rows. I can finish the last row with slip stitch and start making the handle. For the handle, I will go chain 2 and then I will insert it a row above. Picking the yarn from row above, slip stitch. I just want my handle not to start at the very bottom, but to start at a little bit higher. Have I done it? So now I will make chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Try to make this in line that it doesn't go screwed. Pick the yarn on top row, somewhere here. And let's make a slip stitch or single crochet, whatever is better for you. And then along this handle, I will place 10 single crochet. And I can attach this last single crochet with the little chain I made before. Make a slip stitch, chain 1, I can put eyes and little mouse here to make it a little bit funnier, and I can make the chain with pom-pom. For the chain, I will make a slip knot. And start making a chain of 22. Let's make pom-pom now, chain of 3, and into the 4th stitch I will make puff stitch, so double crochet, another double crochet, they are unfinished double crochets. Let's make 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. This little first chain will represent my first double crochet, so I need to make 1 more. I have 5 loops on my hook. Pull through, chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and let's make all the same into the top stitch, one, two, three, and one more. I have 5 loops on my hook, pull through together, chain 1, and then I will fold it in, creating a pom-pom. This is pom-pom stitch you can find along the blankets or on the jumpers. I will connect this into the first, very first stitch. And make another slip stitch or single crochet into the next chain just to secure this. Chain 1 and you can cut the yarn. I will weave the ends. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials if you haven't done so. I've got lots more ideas to come. And this is how it will work. Next row, the pattern will be 2 single crochet and 2 single crochet into the same stitch. So 1, 1 and 2. One single crochet and 2 single crochet. 1, 1, 2. I will go till the end of the row.